now, Brian Kemp, who's our current Secretary of State, should go down in history as the worst Secretary of State we've ever had in Georgia. Brian Kemp purged thousands of votes off the registration list because he was afraid Georgia was going to turn blue in 2016. Now he has the audacity to run for governor. But, silver lining, we have a young man waiting in the wings to be our next secretary. Waiting in the wings to be our next Secretary of State. He's a former congressman. He came back because he got tired of sitting on the sidelines and watching our state go down the drain by the Republican Party. John Barber.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good evening.
Good evening.
My name is John Barrow, and I am proud to be the Democratic nominee for Secretary of State of Georgia. With the chairman, so we have a young man over here looking around, I wonder if somebody else has gotten on the ballot ahead of me. Y'all looking at the diversity of the ticket. I hope y'all know that. We have a ticket that young, female, smart, hip, brilliant, and they figured a little something to round out the ticket, so that's where I come in. A little bit of background on me. I was a county commissioner for 14 years, and then I saw there was a need to do something about the quality of representation we had in Washington. And I thought there was an opportunity to do something about it. So I ran for Congress in 2004, and when I was elected that year, I was the first Democrat to represent my area of the country in the U.S. House of Representatives in a decade, and the first to defeat an incumbent Republican in the Deep South in a quarter of a century. For which I was immediately rewarded for my efforts by being gerrymandered right out of my home county. The very next morning they were working on maps that cut my home county out of the district, made my district substantially more Republican than it was, and I moved my flag all the way from Athens down to Savannah to take my stand down in what was the largest city that was left in what was left of the district that had elected me. And in 2006, I won the roughest, the toughest, and the closest election in Congress that entire year. 864 votes out of a quarter of a million cast. And it drove the gerrymanderers in Atlanta absolutely crazy. Because I won a district that was designed to elect a Democrat first, then I won a district that was redesigned to elect a Republican. Well, they threw more people and more money my way, and my district quickly became the most competitive district in the country. And they weren't satisfied with that. They gerrymandered me again. They cut Savannah out of the district. So I moved my flag from Savannah to Augusta, which was the largest city that was left in what was left of the district that had elected me. And I took my stand there, and I won again. This really drove me crazy. Finally, I was released on my own recognizance. And then comes 2016, and I see that there is a need and an opportunity again. The need is to elect a new Secretary of State. And for us to do the electing. Because it's been 12 years since the voters chose our Secretary of State in an open seat. Not since Karen Handel won it back in 2006. Have we had an open seat where we get to decide who our next Secretary of State is going to be? There's another level of need. This is an important job. Probably the most important job that nobody knows anything about or cares about. But the 700,000 people in this state. It's the most important office in state government. That's how many professionals, licensed professionals, depend on that office for the license they've got to have in order to practice their profession or do their business. So for 700,000 people, 700,000 families, and 700,000 small businesses, it is the most important job in state government all the time. For all the rest of us, it's important that it's important to us at a critical time. At election time. The Secretary of State is the person that we hire to make sure that our elections are fair. And you cannot say that our elections are fair if it's a whole lot easier for some folks to register to vote than it is for others to register to vote. If it's a whole lot easier for some folks to stay registered to vote than it is for others. And if it's a whole lot easier for some folks to vote on election day than it is for a whole lot of others. It does not mean anything to have an equal right to vote if you don't have an equal practical opportunity to vote. And I'm Secretary of State. You also hired a Secretary of State to make sure that your votes are counted exactly the way you cast them. And you're using the machine right now, thanks to the indifference, the laziness, the lack of concern about his job of our current Secretary. We use machines right now. You not only can't have a recount, you can't have a count, because there is nothing to count. Working with a sorry Secretary of State who don't know his job, don't care about his job, and don't want to do his job, like going bird hunting and having to tote the dog. We need somebody who cares about the job, knows about the job, and wants to do the job. And here's the bonus point for those of us who are concerned about the direction in which our country is headed and in which our state has been headed quite some time now. If you care about the direction in which our country is headed, you care about this office for more reasons than you realize. Because if you believe, as I do, that making it harder for some folks to register, making it harder for some folks to stay registered, making it harder for some folks to vote, actually has an impact on elections, if you think that's the case, then you also have to believe that taking the Secretary of State thumb off the scale will allow our electorate in this state to look more like our population in this state. And when that happens, we're going to be able to compete at a more effective level statewide. I would venture to say this state will be in play in 2020, provided we take the office of Secretary of State in 2018 and run it the way it's supposed to be, on the up and square for a change. If you want a Secretary of State who's going to do that, ask for your vote, and I'd be proud to have your support. Thank you all very much.